wala ikaw magigamit sa Diyos na mahimong ma-share ang gospel sa Ginoo. So that's why, if you have the heart for the unbelievers, you will share to other people. Wala mo kabantay mga kaigsunan nga nung mag-encourage you ka sa matagusta, nga mag-invite ka sa ating mga kasilinganan or sa mga tao nga wala pa nakaila sa Diyos, nga nung mag-share ka sa gospel sa mga katawan nga atong mag-ilang ang gala. Because God wanted nga natin kasing-kasing para nila. Now, I have here a question. Do you have heart for the unbelievers? Do you have heart for the loved ones na wala pa sa Ginoo? Amen ba? So if you have the love, if you have the heart, if somebody will scold you na anong wala ka mo duol sa Diyos, may isa siya kinatawa na naayos ka na kung kasing-kasing ni mo. Tungod kay ganahan siya nga maato ka sa tarong makaigunan. And that's why, palihin ko kingon sa imong silingan, don't be selfish. I have a heart for you. Meaning to say, makaigtunan, if mapandol ka, mawala ka, kasala ka, I am here to follow up you. I am here to pray for you. I am here to back you up in prayer and help you in any means I can help. If na ako dagang salapi o bahandi, I will give it to you. Basta ikaw lang mabalik na atubangan sa Ginoo. Because when we say heart, makaigtunan, this is a concern. Nga dili lang ko malipay nga ako ra magsimba sa Ginoo. Ang akong kalipay nga siya nga akong gihigugma kauban ni maglipay ug magsimba sa Dios. Amen ba? Because pati kayo siguro kung ikaw selfish ka nga pag pamilya o pinembro sa pamilya, taw-taw pag ice cream ang imong pamilya wala ka on, dili din mo kaya na siya if ever selfless ka sa tao. But then if selfish ka, kaya ra nimo. But we are called to be selfless. That's why dili na to kaya na kita lang ang mga malipay, magkista sa kalipay, and ang Diyos maayo sa itong kinabuhi. And that's why if you are truly a person who loves God, you shall share, you shall have the heart to evangelize your loved ones, your silingan, and anybody else na imong may suryahan makaigdunan. Because you are a true Christian. Now, as you can see makaigdunan, I have here some observations. Okay, na ay mga sub-observations na ito makita din ay usang klaseng mga tao na sa karon. Okay, let me read to you verse 21, or verse 1 in Romans 10. Romans 10:2. I bear them witness that they have zeal for God, but not according to knowledge. So, naapoy, nabatyagan, nakita agad natin kung naa sila'y kadasig sa Dios or para sa Dios, pero dili kini siya pinasikad sa kaalam, yun ay sulat kiri sa Biblia. So, the first observation na ang mga katawan nato karon makaitunan is number one, they are zealous for God, but not according to the Bible. Nasabtan ninyo makaigtunan. If you're going to observe the Philippines, there are many Filipinos who are so-called religious. Amen? And they have zeal for God. In fact, ang ilang pagto isa nangalagad sila sa Diyos. Ang ilang pagto nga ilang gibuhat, mauni ang para sa Ginoo malipay ang Diyos. But God told us that it's possible also, makaigtunan, that you are so zealous for God, you are so in love for God, and all you have thought na lipay ang Diyos sa imong gibuhat, but then, ang imong gipangbuhat, dili pinasikad sa pulong sa Diyos, maong nga kaalam sa Diyos na yung gisulat din sa Biblia. And that's why, makaigtunan, it is not enough to be sincere in serving God. Amen ba? Because you can be sincerely wrong, and you can serve God sincerely, but in the wrong way. There is a way that we will serve God. There is a way wherein we will come to God. And there must be sincerity also. Now, in this case, makaigtunan, sincerity is not enough basis of truthfulness. Man can be sincerely wrong. Sabta na ito, makaigtunan. Posibli man na ako may gugmaw sa katao, sincere ito. But sa'yo, ako kumaagi. Same thing with our God. You can love God, dakti ka atubangan sa Diyos, but in sa'yo, pang-imong, pamaagi tungod kay dili pinasikad sa kaalam na gihatag sa Dios nato nga masikat nga makita nato dinhi sa Biblia. So nobody can go wrong when the Bible is faithfully followed. Amen ba? If you faithfully follow the Bible in its proper context and interpretation, you can never go wrong. You are infallible. Meaning to say, dili ka masipya sa imong pangbuhaton sa Dios. The only time when we deviate, when we leave the Bible and we believe more on the teachings and opinions of men rather than what is written in the Bible, that is the starting point of our decline, of our spirituality. Makaigtunan, kung sa panahon na mas atutuhuan ang mga kalam sa mga katawan, Nibitansintang ang abanggitang tao kahit sa pulong sa Diyos, mauna ang sinugdanan sa iyong pagkahagbo sa iyong spirituhanan niya. Inilalang sa Diyos. Why? Because God designed that we will eat the Word of God, not the words and opinion of men. Amen? And that's why if you want to grow in Christian faith, go to the Bible, go to the Word of God. Because you can serve God with sincerity at the same time, right knowledge based on the Bible. So the point here is that being sincere is not enough. And it's not a guarantee that you are right. Naiingon mga kaigsunan, anyway, okay lang na ako din ni. Anyway, nagsimba ko sa Diyos o ako sincere nga pagsimba sa Diyos. Kapag ang pangutana, ang imong gipangbuhat na imong gitunguhan para sa Diyos na subay ba na sa Biblia? Because bisan pa usa ka sincere, kung wala may subay sa Biblia, dili gyapon ka padulong sa langit. Mga kaigsunan, sincere kay kung muato ko sa SM, pero ako bisakyan, serious padulong sa Oslo. Bisa kung saon ako pagkasintiro, mga kaintunan, never di ko muabot sa SM kay padulong di ko sa Oslo. Amen ba? Much like the same thing, mga kaintunan, in our spirituality. What the purpose God gave us the Bible? For accurate and be informed of what is knowledge and sincerity to God. God is sincere to us. We need also to be sincere and right in our service to God. The second nga kung makita ang makaisunan din sa Bible wherein also be applied sa mga katauhan nato karon is in verse 3 sa Romans 10. Ingon din he, for being ignorant, ingon ang Bible, dili ako, being ignorant of the righteousness that comes from God and seeking to establish their own, they did not submit to God's righteousness. Makaisunan, kung saan may tanaw niyo sa word ignorant, ganahan mo ingon ignorante. And God told His people that He is ignorant of the righteousness of God. Unsa man ang righteousness of God? Mauning pagkamatarong madawat nato gikan sa Dios. Karon sa mata makaingon nga matarong sa atubangan sa Ginoo. Sa dihang mutuo ta sa Dios, itid manduluwas when we accept the Lord Jesus as Lord and Savior and that we will repent of our sins at the time we can have righteousness of God. But many people wanted to have any other ways aside from what I have mentioned. Tungod kay ganahan sila nga kay tungod wala sila kay bawgit mga kaigsunan, mautahan natin sa upang mga katawan din. Usa may paagi padulong sa langit. Ang usual tubag, magbuhat po mayang buhat. Ang usual tubag, ako ning buhaton, gili na po mabuhat. Ani, usually maon ang ilang tubag, di ba? But then, that's wrong. And sign of ignorance, mga kaigsunan. Going to heaven is not doing something and is not doing something. Going to heaven is about a gift and a free gift, mga kaigsunan, through faith. Now, kung makita natin, mga kaigsunan, are you familiar with the statement, ignorance of the law excuses no one? Mga kaigsunan, bisan pagwaka kay bawo sa balaod, kung balaod na siya, dili ka makaigsot sa penalty or sa kapungot sa Dios. Especially, kung masahan, mga kaigsunan, ignorance of the law excuses no one, especially if the accessibility, nearness and simplicity of the gospel is undeniable. Nasabda na ito, mga kaigsunan. Kung ang pulong sa Diyos, kung ang mensahe sa Diyos, grabe na kayo ka accessible. Nasabda na ito, accessible. Yes. Doon na dyan kayo na ito. Sa internet, sa Bible, sa ating silingan dagang mag-share, doon na dyan kayo na ito ang pulong sa Diyos, hindi na ito gita mo ito. That is unexcusable to God. Especially if near kayo ang gospel na to, mismo ang atong pamilya, mo share sa gospel dito mo to, near na dito kayo, that is unacceptable to God. And especially if it is so simple, gigamit, bisaya na gina, di ka kayo, Ginoo, di ko kasabot ng Hebrew or Greek. Sa una po, pagkaluwas. Ginoo, di ko kasabot ng English. We have Bisaya Bible. And in fact, mga kasuhanin, mag-share po sa Bisaya. Therefore, the gospel of God has been so accessible, so near and so simple to us that in no way we have an excuse to God. Amen ba?
Amen.
That's why if you are ignorant to the gospel of God, then God will hold accountable to you. Muna mga kaigsunan, we need to understand that ignorance of the Bible will really make you look for another way in order to be in heaven. Kung ikaw wala kay bawo sa Biblia, ang imong una-unaon, mangita kag pamaagi, laing pamaagi o dalan para ikaw makatong langit. Motong ingon ni Dr. Hayden ko, makaigsunan, nga nangita sa tubag sa iyang problema muna, iyang gi-devour. Ginigamit na devour mo, gikaon din niya ang psychology nga book, ang mga philosophical nga book, and naasay usa ka Bible, usa ka libro nga wala di siya nagtuo, nga maura ito yung makatubag, wa niya una-unaa. And that is the Bible. And makaigsunan, the Bible will lead us to
the way nga atong makita diha na kaigsoonan. Now, let me read to you Matthew 22:29. Matthew 22:29. But Jesus answered them, "You are wrong. Napayok ug natipiyat ka, yung naniya ang mga Sadducees ug mga Pharisees, because you know neither the scriptures nor the power of God." Wala ka kahibaw sa pulong sa Dios, ug wala pud ka kahibaw sa gahom sa Dios. Meaning to say, knowing the scripture of God is knowing the power of God. Nobody can know the power of God unless he knows the Bible. If a person does not know the Bible, he does not know the power of God, because the word of God is the power of God. Two double-edged sword that will really shatter your heart, even the marrow of your bones. Tingnan mo makaigunan sa Hebrews 4:12. Ang pulong sa Diyos, gamhanan, makausab sa tao. That's why it is my belief, makaigunan, if a person will read the Bible will change the man, not the man will change the book. Amen?
Kung
ikaw magbasa ng Bible, makaigunan, bati man eh, Ginoo, di ko ganahan ani. Ganahan kong buhat ang butangan, di ka ganahan ako ani. Baka, Ginoo, usbon ko eh, no. You cannot change the Word of God. Hindi mo mausap ang pulong sa Ginoo. It is the Word of God that will change you. Amen ba?
Amen.
At pagpaki ang Ginoo, makaigunan, why? God, thank you because of God. That's why you are here. Mabitong naaka, tingot kayo usap na ka sa Diyos. Eka wala pa kausap sa Ginoo, asa ka karong panahonan. And in fact, dagang mga katawahan makaisunan, ganahan mausap. And the problem is that they do not know kung saan pagdool sa Diyos. Tingot kayo grabe na tayo, paninaw nilangin lang sa lahat. Now in this case, it is our privilege that we have God in our lives. So in this case, makaisunan, we need to understand that para makaibaw sa pagahong kung para masakto ka sa itong pagpangalagad sa Ginoo, hibawi ang pulong sa Ginoo. Basaha ang pulong sa Ginoo. Mayroon sa anyway, ang pulong sa Diyos, ang Bible, para sa pari, para sa pastora. Wrong. Kita naman eh, mukhaon sa pirtuhan ng pagtaon, ang pari o pastora. Wrong. Everybody of us are part of the body of Christ, and we are spiritual being of Christ. Therefore, we will eat the Word of God. And therefore, it's not enough na maminaw ta sa pulong sa Diyos. We need to check if atong nadungog na abagit na ito sa Bible. That's why it is our emphasis na kaigsunan niya. Ang makagpistuhanon mo, basa sa pulong sa Diyos, tungkol kay mauna, ang makahimo niyang gili sayok sa iyong atubangan sa Ginoo. Makaigsunan, makadawat ba mo na for your 50 years in existence in this life, nangalagad ka sa Ginoo? But at the moment na ikaw nangatubang sa Ginoo, inyong sayok ka. For 50 years, oh God, I was wrong! Walay laing panahon nga ako nakaamgo. That's why, kinahanglan ka makaigdunan. Ako make sure. Na din yung masayang, sigil sa katulik, butang ka lang. Ato kinabuhi, hindi kalibutanan. Because God will really wanted that our life, our living, or our life shall be right in His life. Now, many people believe in many ways. Daghang mga tao, daghang nagtuo, nga daghang pong paagi padulong sa langit. And many things to do. Daghang pong buhatos para ang atong langit. And the life that's to be saved is they do not know the scriptures. That's why makaigsunan, dili ka mahigong kasi mga tao wala magbasa sa Bible, daghan kayo silang buhaton grid para sila maluwas, daghan kayo mga rituals silang buhaton para sila maluwas, daghan po silang duulat o pangayang tawang para lang grid maluwas. And katong tao nga nakaibaw sa Biblia, makaigsunan, will come to God, come to Jesus because they know the way. I have here a question, how much do you know your Bible? Kung ka man nimo kaibaw ang imong Biblia, makaigsunan, the Bible may just be a book, but it will surely change the course of your destiny in eternity. Natabka na ito, makaigunan. Posible nga libro ra na siya, masunog na siya. But then, ang thought niya na makaigunan, makausap sa dagan sa inyong kinabuhi, bisan pa nining, human nining kinabuhi niya, ang eternity. And that is the thing, the most important thing in our lives, makaigunan. That's why you ask your neighbor, ignorant ka ba? Hopefully, you will say, hindi naman ako ignorant, brother. So the point, makaigsunan, that I want to share is that if you are a person who loves God and if you love yourself, you shall not choose to be ignorant and you shall love your Bible, read your Bible, meditate on it, and apply on it daily and also in night, makaigsunan, because that will really direct you to the true way to heaven. Now, another thing, makaigsunan nga, maato makita rin sa mga tao na bi-describe sa Ginoo dili, which is still true today, number 3 in verse 3. For being ignorant of the righteousness that comes from God, tanawa, next, and seeking to establish their own. But what about
Kaya ignorante man sila sa kamaagi sa Dios para ang tao maluwas, ilang buhat, magbuhat na lang sa sila sila ha, paagi para maluwas sila. Meaning to say, man are a good inventor on how to go to heaven. They are the great inventor of many things. Makita na ito, makaito na, if you go to the market, di ka kauna-una na abang, posible din yung may tabo. Sa una, imposible kayong mag-isturya ko sa Taga Manila on the time madunog na ko ang isturya. Now, pero it's possible because of technology, because of cell phones, because of many things, posible din makaitunan na mabuhak na ito ang mga imposible before. Diba? Because man is by nature a good inventor. And that's the good side there. But the bad thing is that giapin nila pag invento ang pulong na usahon pag-atog langit o usahon yung mahimot ang matarong atubangan sa Diyos. Now, because you are ignorant of the true way, then there is a tendency that you will invent on how to go to the heaven. So ignorance of the Bible will lead you to invent other ways. You are so easy to accept many things and believe also in many doctrines that is not right in the Bible. Nasabda na ito mga isunan. Ang katong mga Kristohan o mga tao na dali kayo mutuong o tuho-tuhoon kaayo, o itong mga tao po na dili magbasa sa Bible. Nasabda na ito. Because if you do not know the truth, it's hard for you to really distinguish if this is true or not. Makita na ito mga isunan. If you really desire to know the fake money, be expert, master the faith of these original money. Sabda na ito makaisinan. Kung makahiba, kung ganahan ka makahibaw sa mga bakpak-bakas na pangasulungan, adto ka sa Pinuod. And you will determine makaisinan that the Bible is the real truth and the real truth na akong hisgutan din makaisinan. So man is a great inventor and to the point that he invented many things that's like to be safe or how to escape hell. Now in this case makaisinan, can you ask your neighbor, inventor ka ba? Ano bang in-invento mo ngayon? Mga kaigdunan, it is good to invent many things for the good of many people. Tinood mga kaigdunindot ng creative mind ka, but ayaw i-appeal na inyong ituis ang pulong sa Diyos para mag-invento kaglain. And that's why there are many ways na mingon, I am the way, I am the Christ in Davao, mingon ko din, I am the vector of Christ in Rome. There are many kinds mga kaigdunan of claims like that. And if you are a person who nagbasa sa Bible, you will determine that that is false and that is not true. Because Jesus said, I am the only begotten Son. And Antichrist will try to replace me. And if a person will try to replace Christ, mauna siya gitawag ng Antichrist mga kaigdunan. So if you truly love God and His people, you shall not invent your own ways on how to go to heaven. You shall not accept any doctors or rituals which does not permitted or teach by the Bible. We need to say a point na go back to the Bible, go back to the basics. Now, in this case, mga kaigdunan, we need to understand that the second point na gusto na ko i-share is in verse 4 to 8. Worry not, I'll try my best to make this simple and quick. The biblical righteousness of God. Di ba, may ngon ko, sige ko, ingon ganiha na ang tao mag-inventong sa'yo, ang tao ignorante sa pulong sa Diyos. Sige kong ingon ni Ana, ako nisgutan na po karoon sa malayin ang tinuod nga pagkamataro. Ang sa malayin ang tinuod na kaluwasan na nihatag sa Diyos na ito. It's in verse 4, and allow me to read this one. For Christ is the end of the law for righteousness to everyone who believes. This means, mga kaigdunan, that only Jesus has successfully fulfilled the law of God. And during His time and during His stay in His life, siya ang tao na naka-perfect sa pag-follow sa law with the right attitude. Mautan na ako, mga kaigdunan, ikaw, nakatuman na baka sa tanang balaod yung ituwag sa Bible? For just one day. Ibutang ka lang for a minute, natuman na to. But in the next minute, mga kaigdunan, there will always be a time wherein we will fail God. And it's given, mga kaigdunan, if you follow the whole commandments of God for a day, but I know we have a wrong motive in doing so, it's still not perfect in God's sight. In fact, James 2:10, mga kaigdunan, naging on, if one person will fail or miss one point of the law, he failed the entire law. And that is the standard of God. The standard of God in going to heaven is perfection. Kaya na ito, mga kaigdunan, dapat na perfecto ka, dapat dili lang nga mag dili lang imong nga dili ta mangawat o dili ta magpakasala tungod kay mahadlok ta may impierno o mahadlok ta ma mapriso kung dili tungod kay nahigugma ta sa Dios, di ba? And that is the right reason why we shall not disobey the law of God. Now, unsa man ang sakto nga pamaagi nga kaigsoon para maluwas ang tao? It's in Ephesians 2:8-9. Are you familiar with that? Naingon ang Ginoo mga kaigsoon sa Ephesians 2:8-9 to the life of Paul, for by grace are you saved through faith, and that is not of your works, lest you will boast. That is the gift of God. Makaigsunan, gasa sa Dios, pinaagi sa pagtuwa ko ng dawaton, ang kaluwasan na ihatag sa Dios nato. And that is the right righteousness, the biblical righteousness na gishare sa Ginoo nato. Now, I have here a question. How would you avail the benefits of the salvation that God gave us? Ang answer, makaigsunan, saan mo nato pag-avail sa kaluwasan na gibuwa sa Christ sa cross? Ang answer, faith. Nanuman, allow me to read again, verse 4, ngayon din ha. For Christ is the end of the law for righteousness to everyone who, what? Who believes. And if a person believes, meaning to say there is faith in his heart. The word believe signifies faith put in Jesus Christ who fulfills the entire law for us. So si Kristo di ay ang ituman sa balaod para nato, natong mga katauhan makaigsunan. Now ang question nato, saan nato pagturo? How would you believe? What would you believe? And the answer, makaigsunan of the question, is the word we proclaim. Ang pulong nga ato, diwali o nadungog. Ganong ingon ko, ana? Let me read to you verse 8. Ingon din ha. But what does it say? The word is near you, in your mouth, in your heart. That is the word of faith that we proclaim. So, maingon na ito, makaigsunan, ang saktong pagtulungan, ang saktong kaluwasan nga itong madawat, pinaadi ay nga atong madawat kini sa pinagi sa pagtuo o kini iwali ni siya, kini iproklamar ni siya sa katawhan. Na unsa man ang characteristics sa word, sa tulong nga akong i-share karon. Ningon ang Bible sa verse 8, near you. Doon na kayo ni mo. Next, ningon sa gabi na, in your mouth, naano sa iyong baba. O kami katulong na kayo tulad, in your heart, naano sa iyong kasing-kasing. So in that case, in no way man can really alibay to God, ginawa ang kibawa ni pulong ni mo, eh. Huwag kibawa na kinahanglan, hindi ko mag-inosulog mo doon ni Jesus as Lord and my Savior. Why? Because the Word of God is so near to you, it's in your mouth, and it's in your heart. And God is really sure of that. Now, can you ask your neighbor, tuon na ba ka sa pulong? Tuon na ka sa pulong ngayon sa dugog? Who is the Word? Mutan ako, bigita man ang inyong hibawan ni pulong. John 1:1 says,
God.
Okay, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Theos. The word Theos refers to Jesus in verse 4, the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. Meaning to say, ang Word nga akong diwali, ang Word nga madungog ni mo makaigsunan sa mga wagwali sa Ginoo, mao si Kristo nga ilang iwali. If a preacher of God will preach other than the name Jesus, cursed be upon him, according to Galatians 1. We need to say, if the Brother Abun or anybody of us will share the gospel, we are sharing the word of Christ. We are proclaiming Jesus, the word. Dili ang tao atong ipataas makaigun kundili si Kristo Jesus. So if you are a genuine believer of God, you shall believe the word of God, the written word of God, and you shall believe also the incarnate word of God, who is Jesus Christ himself. Now, makita na ito makaigsunan, the third point na gusto na ko share under this sharing. In verse 9 to 10, worry not, kapit na Diyos. Let me read to you verse 9, if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord. Are you familiar with the statement, Jesus is Lord? And in fact, this is one of the verses wherein our community and our church is clinged upon. This is very biblical. Believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. Verse 10. For with the heart one believes and is justified, and with the mouth we confess and is saved. Number one there, for you to be saved, there must be a public declaration that Jesus is Lord. Mangutan na po mga kaibigan, if you are just one, and if you are asked to declare the statement, Jesus is Lord, can you do that? Kaya nimo makaigdunan i-declare musaget ka that Jesus is Lord bisan palibot nimo kalibutan o bisan palibot nimo dili magtotoo ni Kristo. God said, when you confess in your mouth that Jesus is Lord, you shall be saved. Can you say that? Can you say with me that Jesus is Lord?
Jesus is Lord.
Amen.
Jesus is Lord, mga kaibigan. That's why the question here is that we are proud that we say Jesus is Lord and Jesus is our God and Savior. Now, the second there, there must be personal belief that Jesus is alive. Diba? First is that public declaration that Jesus is God. Second is a personal belief that Jesus is alive. Ganun sa verse. Ganun ba? Ingon man din sa verse 9. Believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead. Is God not dead? He is alive. He is surely alive. Diba? He's like a lion roaring, meaning to say, mga kaigdunan, buhay siya na Diyos. And he answered prayer. And in fact, he answered our prayer. Amen. And it's proven because there's logo there. Okay, na yung logo, mga kaigdunan, it's subag sa pag-ampo. And I know God is answering more of our prayers. That's why we will not stop praying unto God. Na makita natin, mga kaigdunan, that we declare that Jesus is Lord over this city. And that we will declare that Jesus is alive over this city. That's why Brother Eddie, when we go to inyong anniversary, ang kanunay niyang introduction is that, join me, say it to me, Jesus is Lord over Caracas City. My our praying is first, God is not dead, Jesus is alive, Jesus is Lord over Caracas City, Jesus is Lord over Cebu Province, Jesus is Lord over Visayas, Jesus is Lord over the Philippines, Jesus is Lord over Asia, Jesus is Lord over the world. Why? Because when you insist and when you declare the Lordship of Jesus, that's the time you are destroying the kingdom of Satan in the place. Amen ba? And that's why next Sunday, we will be doing that with Pastor Carlos Mutada, our speaker for our anniversary, wherein ato we declare once again, na ato we cry last October 2013, sa peak of the mountain. Okay, niya na ito sa location sa Karkar, the same thing that Jesus is Lord over Karkar City. Why? Because we do believe that God is really doing mighty things in this city. Amen ba? And there is yet death to come, mga kaibigan.